हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रय शिक्षण संस्था रोज प्रोजेक्ट फॉर 11 साइंस कंडक्टेड बाय यशवंतराव चव्हाण इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ साइंस सातारा. मायसेल्फ पल्लवी उत्कर्ष भोसले, आई एम फिजिक्स टीचर. वी विल डिस्कस टॉपिक ऑप्टिक्स. लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन 9.1, 9.2 एंड 9.3. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss 9.4, that is a reflection and related concept A, B, C, D, related to reflection. Reflection from plane surface, reflection from curved mirror, image formation for concave mirror depends upon the position of the object. Last point, defects or aberration of the images. All of you know types of mirrors and lenses. We have learned in last year types of mirrors and lenses. All of you know, and we use many mirrors and lenses in daily use. This is a plane mirror, concave mirror, convex mirror, convex lens and concave lens. All these are types of mirrors and lenses. या मिरर सगळ्या तुम्हाला परिचित आहेत आणि याचा यूज आपण रेग्युलर जीवनामध्ये पण बऱ्याच ठिकाणी करतो. दररोज आरशात पाहिल्याशिवाय आपण बाहेर पडत नाही. तसंच कॉनकेव मिरर, कॉन्वेक्स मिरर हे वेगवेगळे ऍप्लिकेशन्स आपण या दैनंदिन जीवनात वापरत असतो. याच्यामध्ये लेन्सचे परत पुन्हा टाईप पडतात. देर इज अ टाईप्स ऑफ लेन्सेस, डबल कॉन्वेक्स, प्लेनो कॉन्वेक्स, दॅट इज अ वन प्लेन सरफेस अँड अदर इज अ कॉन्वेक्स. कॉन्केओ कॉन्वेक्स, दॅट इज दिस वन. अँड डबल कॉन्केव, दॅट मीन्स बोथ साइड्स आर कॉन्केव, म्हणजे दोन्ही बाजू अशा खोलगट असतात. प्लेनो कॉन्केव, दॅट मीन्स वन प्लेन अँड वन कॉन्केव सरफेस. अँड कॉन्वेक्सो कॉन्केव, लास्ट लेन्स इज अ कॉन्वेक्सो कॉन्वेक्स. ह्या लेन्सेसचा टाइप्स तुम्हाला माहिती असणं गरजेचं आहे, म्हणून फक्त इथे एक्सप्लेन केलेले आहेत. आपण मिररवरच फोकस करणार आहोत. मिरर बद्दल जे काही आपल्याला रिफ्लेक्शन या गोष्टी आपल्याला शिकायच्या आहेत, या लेक्चरमध्ये आपण ते पाहणार आहोत. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी स्पेरिकल मिरर रिलेटेड टू बेसिक कन्सेप्ट. ऑल ऑफ यू ऑलरेडी यू हॅव लर्न्ड लास्ट इयर, बट नाऊ आय वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस some or I want to repeat all points. All of you know this is a spherical mirror. Okay, ya spherical mirror pasun apan concave mirror, convex mirror ya tayar karto. Mai he kasa tayar karat asel, what how to form a concave mirror or convex mirror, tar lakshat gayte ita ekha spherical mirror cha ekada bhag cut kela, side ek cut keli ani tacha outer kiwa inner surface पॉलिश केला, तर त्याच्यावरून आपण कॉन्केव किंवा कॉन्वेक्स मिरर डिसाइड करतो. सपोज हिअर एम पी एम डॅश कट हिअर अँड आउटर सरफेस विल बी पॉलिश्ड अँड इनर सरफेस विल बी रिफ्लेक्टिंग, देन दिस इज अ कॉन्केव मिरर. म्हणजे आपण काल मी एक चमच्याचं उदाहरण दिलेलं की चमच्यामध्ये आपण या बाजूनं किंवा या बाजूनं अशी इमेज पाहू शकतो. त्याच पद्धतीनं ज्याचा आतला भाग रिफ्लेक्टिंग असेल आणि बाहेरचा भाग पॉलिश केलेला आहे, सो दिस इज अ कॉन्केव मिरर. आता कॉन्वेक्स मिरर करायचे तर बाहेरचा भाग हा रिफ्लेक्टिंग हवा अँड इनर पोर्शन विल बी पॉलिश्ड. ठीक आहे, याच्यामध्ये बेसिक कन्सेप्ट काय आहे? रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर दिस वन आर, सी टू पी दिस डिस्टन्स इज अ रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर. म्हणजे स्पियरची जी रेडियस आहे, that means radius of curvature of that lens, sorry, mirror. Principal axis, this is a principal axis, and r radius, f is a focal length of this mirror. All of you know relation between focal length and radius of curvature. F is equal to r by 2. This is a basic relation, all of you know. Now some important definitions regarding spherical mirrors. All of you know pole or vertex. Suppose this is a one of the mirror, this point is a pole. Okay, p, this point p is a nothing but pole or vertex. It is the geometrical center of the spherical reflecting surface. Second one, center of curvature. In last side, we can see center of curvature of this mirror, that is the radius of this sphere, that is the center of curvature. The center C of the sphere of which the spherical mirror is a part is the center of curvature of the mirror. Next one, radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is the radius R of the sphere of which mirror forms a part. लक्षात घ्या, focal length, radius of curvature म्हणजे R आपण consider केलं की त्या sphere ची radius आहे. या सगळ्या concept तुम्हाला माहिती आहेत. Image formation by mirror. Image formation कसं होतं mirror पासून? तर basic आणि खूप सोप्या शब्दात मी सांगते. Parallel ray incident on this mirror and it reflect and going through or passing through this focal length. म्हणजे parallel आलेला ray हा focus मधून pass होतो. हा एक rule आहे. Suppose focus मधून second ray बघा. Focus मधून गेलेला जो ray आहे तो parallel जातो. ठीक आहे? बघा parallel आलेला ray it goes through focus and focus मधून आलेला it goes through again parallel to this principal axis. See carefully formation of mirror, yeah, image formation by mirror. कारण की या गोष्टी समजल्या तर या टॉपिक मधल्या बऱ्याचशा गोष्टी तुम्हाला कळतात. कारण की इमेज फॉर्मेशन करता आलं पाहिजे. हे बघा आणि सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर, रे पासिंग थ्रू सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर, सो इट गोज स्ट्रेट अँड रीट्रेसेस इट्स ओरिजिनल पाथ. See here, second figure. Suppose this AC is incident on this C point or center of curvature. Then this ray goes through straight way and incident on this mirror and reflected back again or retraces its original path. Also, image formation by lenses is a very important part. Same rule. कॉन्केव मिरर, कॉन्वेक्स मिरर, मिरर साठी जे रूल आहे ते आपण इथे पण सेम वापरतो. म्हणजे आलेला पॅरल रे जो आहे तो फोकस मधून पास होतो. जर फोकस मधून गेला तर तो पॅरल जातो आणि सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर किंवा पोल मधून, पोल मधून गेला तर तोही स्ट्रेट जातो. लक्षात घ्या या गोष्टी आपल्याला माहिती असणं गरजेचं आहे. सी हियर अगेन ऑल दीज इनकमिंग रेज ऑर पॅरल रेज. ओके and this is a concave mirror, focal point of this mirror, center of curvature, and this is a radius of curvature, and this is a focal length. Focal length is a half of this radius of curvature. Remember important points, that is a focal length is a half of radius of curvature. Next important point, that is a paraxial rays or marginal rays. What is a paraxial rays and marginal rays? Paraxial rays, the incident ray which are close to principal axis are called a paraxial ray. Ha, paraxial ray manje kay, tar je kahi lens var kiwa mirror var je padnare rays ahe te axis la near astil kiwa close astil ashe je rays astat tar te je rays ahe te paraxial rays ahe. Marginal rays, marginal rays, that means the incident ray which are far away from the principal axis are called a marginal ray. See figure here, this is a marginal ray. Okay, and this is a paraxial ray. First figure shows paraxial rays, it is a close to the principal axis, and here away from the principal axis as compared to this paraxial ray. सो फोकस विल बी चेंज. आताच आपण काय बघितलं, इमेज फॉर्मेशन कसं होतं, पॅरल येणारे जे रे आहेत तर ते फोकस मध्ये मिळतात. पण इथं फोकस जर ती सेम लेन्स आपण युज केली असेल पण पॅरल आणि पॅरॅक्सिल आणि मार्जिनल रेचा युज करून फोकस चेंज होतो, सो डिफेक्ट विल बी ऑकर. ठीक आहे, म्हणजे याच्यामध्ये काहीतरी डिफेक्ट्स आहे, तो डिफेक्ट म्हणूनच लक्षात घ्या. एक इम्पॉर्टंट नोट सांगते, ओनली पॅरॅक्सिल रेज आर इन्वॉल्व इन अ image formation.
Let us move on new point. that is a 9.4 reflection. We want to find the images when two mirrors are inclined to each other and object placed between them. Reflection from the plane surface. Here two mirrors are inclined with angle and object is placed here. How to find the number of images formed by this mirror? So this is a formula to find the number of images. N is equal to 360 by theta. Condition first, if n is a even integer, n is equal to n minus 1, object is anywhere. Condition is object is anywhere. So suppose here two mirrors are inclined with some angle, that is theta is equal to 60 degree. Then find the number of images. Here n is equal to 360 by 60. We get answer 6. Number of images is equal to 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Because here n is a even integer. 6 is an even integer. Answer of this formula. And we get total number of images because answer is even integer and object is anywhere. So this object placed at anywhere between this mirror, then we get the number of images 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Next condition, if n is an odd integer and object is at the angle bisector. Condition is at the angle bisector. Object placed at the angle bisector. What is mean? Suppose theta is equal to 40 degree. Two mirrors is there. And angle between them is a 40. And object placed at the bisector. That means symmetry. Or at an angle 20. This middle place here where angle is a 20. Because theta between these two mirrors is a 40. So this object placed at a 20 degree. So number of images will be n minus 1. That is a here theta between these two mirrors is equal to 40. So divide 360 divided by 40. We get the number of n is equal to n. This is a odd integer. But object is at the angle bisector. So number of images capital N is equal to N minus 1. So we get answer 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. Third condition, if N is an odd integer and object is of the angle bisector. Look here, theta is equal to 40 degree. And suppose this object of the angle bisector, that is not symmetry. That is here angle between these two mirror is a 40 and object placed at a 15 degree between these two mirrors. So this object of the angle bisector. Now calculate the number of images. So n is equal to 360 divided by 40, we get n. N is an odd integer, but object placed at the, object placed of the angle bisector. So we get final images, n is equal to 9. Next condition, condition number 4. If the n is not integer, n is equal to m, where m is the integral part of n. So now calculate. Suppose theta is equal to 35 degree. Then we get n is equal to 360 divided by 35. We get this integer n 10.28. So what is the number of images here? N is equal to 10. That is a only integer part.
Now we will move on a new concept related to reflection from curved mirror. See here, object placed at the center of curvature. We get the image from this object here at a same distance, that is a twice f from this pole. Here parallel ray and this is the incident ray pass through this focus and we get the image at a C. Next, suppose object placed between the F and pole of this mirror. We get the image like that way. See carefully, parallel rays and ray passes through focus. We get the image, virtual image here. Again, we get here next, suppose object placed beyond the C. So object distance will be increased here than twice F. So we get the image distance between F and C. All these images or pictures, see carefully. We get the idea related to image, how to form the images. Next, when we put object between C and F, then we get image beyond C, that is a twice F. There is a here image distance will be increased here. From all these images, we can conclude when we put the object at a twice F, image will be get here at a twice F. When we get put object between F and pole, we get virtual image will be magnified than this object. And here when we put the object beyond the twice F, then image distance will be decreased here. And when we put the object between C and F, then image distance will be increased here. New point related to this concave mirror. So this is a images related to we have seen here last slide. So we get the different images when put the object at a different place. See carefully. All of you know mirror equation, that is a 1 upon F is equal to 1 upon V plus 1 upon U. We have already learned in last year. What is a lateral magnification? M is equal to V upon U. That is a image distance, ratio of image distance to the ratio of object distance. V upon U. Similar way, we can write here power of this lens, that is 1 upon F. What is the SI unit then? F is a focal length and we measured in a meter. So its SI unit, meter inverse, that is 1 upon M, that is a meter inverse. Similar way, we can see images by this convex mirror. Here, put here object at a different places. We get a image distance at a different points. See here in first, object beyond C. We get the image at a between F and pole. And when we put the object between C and F, we get the image F and between F and pole. So from all these images or ray diagram, we can conclude that image from this convex mirror, it is a diminished and virtual.
Let us move on a new point, that is defects and spherical aberration for mirrors. All of you know basic principal rays, that is coming from this focus, center of curvature. See carefully, we get the image at this point. All these rays, related relations, all of you know, we get final image here. Now see second figure. This is the incident ray, incident on this concave mirror. And this incident ray, it is parallel to the principal axis. So it meet at a focus point. And what is the defects and spherical aberration for mirrors? What is the restrictions for having images produced by spherical mirrors to be appreciable clear? How to minimize the error of this spherical aberration of for mirrors? Now, see these figures. Here, this is the principal axis of this concave mirror. And here is a convex mirror here. Here, two part that is for rays, paraxial rays and marginal rays. What about paraxial rays? It is very close to the principal axis and it is parallel to the principal axis. But marginal ray is further away or away from this principal axis. All these parallel rays not meet at the same point or same focus. Here, focus will be changed for parallel and paraxial and marginal rays. So defects occur in a final image. So in case of spherical mirror, we can minimize the error and by using parabolic mirror. Now see, we will see here circle of least confusion. Circle of least confusion, that means optical spot caused by a cone of a ray, light rays from a lens not coming to perfect focus when imaging a point source. Here parallel, paraxial rays and marginal rays not meet at a same focus. So there is a different focus. Our figure shows here FM and FM here and FP. FP, that is a focus of paraxial rays, and here focus for marginal ray is different. So circle of least confusion, that means optical spot caused by cone of light rays from a lens or mirror not coming to perfect focus when imagine a point source. See here, circle of least confusion. Then next point is a longitudinal spherical aberration. The distance between the paraxial focal plane and the place where the ray crosses the optical axis. The distance between the paraxial focal plane and the place where the ray crosses optical axis. Transverse spherical aberration, that is a radius of circle of least confusion is transverse spherical aberration. Remedies for spherical aberration. See here, parabolic surface and spherical aberration is here. See here, parallel beams, all rays, parallel rays not meet at the same focus. So when we use the parabolic surface instead of spherical surface, we get a same focus. See here again, this is a spherical mirror. Here all paraxial rays coming at this focus and a marginal rays, which is away from the principal axis, meet at a new focus. So blur image will be obtained or aberration is there. when we use the parabolic mirror instead of the spherical mirror, we get the same focus point of image. From this incident rays, we get all rays meet at a same focus. So we can use the parabolic mirror instead of spherical mirror. See here, next figure. We can clear here our ideas. Small spherical mirror. Here large spherical mirror. Here curvature of this mirror is a large. Here small. And again we use here parabolic mirror. We get the same focus point. We get the clear image from this parabolic, using parabolic mirror.